Welcome to The Source, where we combine the headlines with in-depth conversations with the newsmakers themselves. Today on the program, a 13-million-hectare undersea region in East Luzon is now creating waves of concerns between the Philippines and China.
Other countries can exercise innocent passage and territorial navigation, but they are disallowed to stay and establish any structure in the area.
A Chinese survey ship was spotted in Benham Rise, causing concern for the country's defense chief.
We should protest. Because, you know, what happens if we do not protest is we just lost by default.
China calls it freedom of navigation. With warmer relations between the two countries, could this possibly put a dent on Philippine-China relations? Congressman Ruffy Biazon shares his thoughts live in the program. And later, a rare violin finds its way back home. That's for today's In Focus. Thank you for joining us. I'm Pinky Webb. The Philippines should not take recent reports of Chinese survey ships in Benham Rise lightly. Well, at least for some lawmakers and maritime experts. Benham Rise is a continental shelf in the eastern seaboard of the country recognized by the United Nations in 2012. The said territory may be holding rich natural resources, which remains to be unexplored. Lawmakers call for stronger security in the area, filing House resolutions and proposing stronger actions while we still have time. Let's go straight to the source of the story, Congressman Ruffy Biazon. Congressman, thank you for being here.
Thank you for inviting me.
You are quite focused on Benham Rise. You seem to know enough about it, even from the time your father was a senator and also a congressman. Tell us why the focus or the interest.
Right now, I am vice chair of the Committee on National Defense, a post which I held even in my previous terms. And of course, my father, Senator, former Senator Biazon, was also occupying the post of
Defense
Committee Chair, as well as having been in the military for a long time. Well, to him, it's kind of nostalgic because he was once assigned in Pagasa Island, the West Philippine Sea. And of course, being a military man, he focused on national security issues. And being him being my mentor, of course, I followed suit.
And there was a map on Twitter you were showing, that there was a map that you were pointing to. What was that all about?
That was a map that came from NAMRIA, our mapping agency. They gave it to Senator Biazon. It basically focused on the eastern part, eastern seaboard of the Philippines, showing where Benham Rise is.
Yeah, and Benham Rise is bigger than Luzon.
Yes, if we take a look at, or if we consider the entire geographical structure of Benham Rise, it's really big, hundreds of thousands of hectares.
I think it's 13 million hectares.
Yes.
That's what they're saying, 13 million hectares of territory over in the Pacific Ocean. Again, let's point out that this is on the east side, Congressman.
Yes.
Of the opposite of what where the South China Sea or West Philippines
is. Yes, if you're looking at the map of the Philippines, it's on the right side, as opposed to the what we usually know about the West Philippine Sea, which is on the left side.
Yeah, let's go back to this, the UN granting the Philippines the Benham Rise. Let's focus on that. Let's dissect that. In 2012, the UN approved the Philippines' claim to Benham Rise. That is part of the country's continental shelf and territory. First of all, what do they mean when they say it's part of the Philippines' continental shelf?
Well, this is all based on the United Nations Convention on the Law of the Sea. It basically lays the legal framework for countries to on how they use the oceans, how do they use and exploit the oceans. So the Philippines has what is called our territorial seas, which is 12 miles from the baseline.
12 miles?
12 nautical miles, yes. That's our territorial waters. Outside of that, up to 200 nautical miles from our baseline, that's the continental shelf.
Mm-hmm.
But sometimes, because of the geographic structure, it is extended. That's called the extended continental shelf.
Okay.
That's where Benham Rise lies.
Are we on the extended continental or just
Benham
the continental
Rise is
shelf?
On the extended continental shelf.
So when the UN said it's part of the Philippine territory, that means that that is part of our extended continental shelf.
We are, UN recognizes our rights over the area as part of our exclusive economic zone.
Mm-hmm.
The 200 nautical miles is the exclusive economic zone.
That's right,
zone, yeah.
From the border of the Philippine
baseline,
map,
yes.
Whether you're north, east, southwest.
Yes.
Okay.
So we are given the rights to explore and exploit under the ocean. Except living creatures which are mobile.
Okay.
Meaning to say those which are swimming.
Fish.
Yeah, fish.
Uh-huh.
But other, they term it as sedentary life
right.
forms.
Mm-hmm.
Basically, they're static there. We have the right to explore and exploit that, including minerals and oil, gas. Yes.
Let's talk about, there is an argument coming out right now that we have sovereign rights over Benham Rise, mm-hmm. but we don't have sovereignty over Benham Rise. Is that
yes,
how you see it as well?
Sovereignty is within our territorial waters. Sovereign rights is that we have the inherent right to use the natural resources there.
Mm-hmm.
But we really cannot stop what they term as innocent passage because
freedom
of the freedom
navigation.
Of navigation. But there is a specific, there is a definition of what innocent passage and freedom of navigation is under UNCLOS.
Mm-hmm.
Like right of innocent passage is, if you simplifying it, it's basically just traveling directly from one point to another. That's innocent passage.
Yeah.
You're just passing through.
Uh-huh.
Freedom of navigation means you're not threatening a particular country.
Okay.
Which has some rights over that particular part of the ocean. So the claim of China is that they were just going on innocent passage.
With marine research. They used also the,
I
term
didn't hear
marine
that.
Research.
So if it was marine research. But Secretary Lorenzana, the defense secretary, said that the observation was it was moving on a crisscrossing pattern, slowing down, moving from one place to another.
For a period of 3 months.
For a period of 3 months. So that does not fit into the definition of what innocent passage is. So I think we are perfectly in a rightful position to ask what the vessel was doing there. And that's what the Department of Foreign Affairs did. They wrote the
note verbal.
The Chinese embassy and asked them to explain.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And this is when the Chinese government, through their foreign minister, said that, yes, last year that happened. And then they said that the Philippines can't claim territorial, cannot do territorial claim on Benham Rise.
Well, what we're saying is that they're not an innocent passage. See, we don't know if they were doing surveys. They can claim that they were doing surveys for marine fish.
Marine research, yeah.
Marine research. But what if they were doing surveys for oil drilling for? Exploitation of mineral resources, then that would venture into our rights.
So here's the thing, you have Secretary Delfin Lorenzana saying that last year they were, the words he used, they were crisscrossing.
Yes.
For 3 months. So what that means is, punta ka dito, babalik ka, iikot ka, parang you're going around the area of Benham Rise.
Yeah, because as defined by UNCLOS, innocent passage, dire-diretso ka lang, ikitawid.
So, does that is that a violation coming from China?
Well, based on what Secretary Lorenzana said, there's a reason for us to believe that they were just doing innocent passage.
Mm-mm. There's no reason, you mean?
Yeah, there's reason for us to doubt that they were really on innocent passage. They have to explain.
So did they violate any international laws?
Well, it's a definition of the definition of innocent passage could have been violated. Therefore, it was a violation of UNCLOS.
What should government do about it, especially the DFA? Understandably, a note verbal was already sent
yes.
To the Chinese government, and any more after that? What should we do?
Well, we can take it to the UN. That would be the diplomatic action that we could take. Of course, that undergoes a lot of process. It's an option. But for now, my personal opinion is that we should really start focusing on securing Benham Rise.
You filed a bill.
It was great. It was in a way granted to us last 2012.
Yeah.
Yes, we've done research around 2014. So Filipino divers have gone there. So we just should continue doing that.
Yeah.
That's one. Show that we are intending to exploit resources that are rightfully ours, and then take steps to secure that area. And what do I mean by that? We have to develop the capability. One is to patrol the area, capability to intercept those who venture illegally into the area, and have a sustained surveillance of the area. Because if we are to check foreign vessels which go on innocent passage, we must have the ability to monitor that they
exactly.
are coming in.
Yeah.
So that at the time that they're there, we can immediately question.
And then you can say at this time, at this date, this ship passed. We need that kind of, we have that?
Right now, on the eastern seaboard, as far as I know, we don't. We have something that is called the National Coast Watch System. It's a series of surveillance radars, equipment, to monitor the West Philippine Sea. So that we have at the West Philippine Sea. The other side, as far as I know, we're lacking.
So it's really time to focus also on the East, especially Benham Rise.
Yes.
But you're filing or you filed a bill?
I'm drafting a bill now to come up with specifics, specific recommendations for a strategic security plan. What I filed as of the moment is a resolution to conduct an inquiry first into the reason why there was Chinese presence there, and second, to find out what is the strategic plan of the government.
Right.
Because as far as Congress is concerned, we are not aware yet of any strategic
plan. There's no strategic plan as of now. Although I do understand that from the Senate, Senator Angara also filed a bill. I was told that he filed a bill, and it somehow wanted to develop the Benham Rise.
That's
Benham
the Benham Rise Development Authority.
Right.
But as I browsed over the bill, it basically just focuses on putting up an entity which will manage Benham Rise as a source of business for the country.
Yeah. Does that sound good to you?
It does. But developing it as a source of business should entail the mechanism to secure it.
Yeah?
First step is to secure.
First step is to secure.
Pag may lupa kang binili, the first step you do is put a fence around it. You don't put up your business right there lang gano, without securing.
Or kapag may lupa ka, di ba? May lote ka. You know, it's also interesting to tell everyone, I mean, to inform ourselves and the people watching us that this is an underwater plateau.
Yes.
Nasa ilalim siya.
There's talk about building structures in
exactly,
Benham Rise.
That's where
you can't. No, I mean, not in the manner that the West Philippine Sea had airfields and everything. Because Benham Rise is underwater. The main Benham Rise itself is about 3,000 meters underwater. So that's the whole, the whole plateau.
Yeah.
Then there's a formation that goes up. It's a smaller formation, and the shallowest part is about 50 meters.
The shallowest part is just 50 meters.
Yeah, that's about 150 feet.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Yun ang pinaka-shallow. So
yes.
It's really time to do some patrolling. You know, we also had the Philippine Coast Guard this week, and its spokesperson, Arman Balilo, was telling us that they're looking at patrolling the east, at least Benham Rise, starting May.
They should, but, you know, that's another area where Congress really has to, government and Congress in particular, has to focus on. It might necessitate us to really putting in resources specifically for Benham Rise. Like, for example, Coast Guard will patrol it. Coast Guard can patrol it now, but they'll be pulling out resources from other areas.
From the West Philippines, yes, exactly.
So we're spreading ourselves too thinly.
That's right. We'll be taking a short break. This is The Source on CNN Philippines. Still to come, more on the issue of Benham Rise and what's also next for the House of Representatives after the passage of the death penalty bill. And later, an almost three centuries old violin makes its way back to the concert stage. That's for today's In Focus. You're watching The Source on CNN Philippines. Our guest today, Congressman Ruffy Biazon. I'd like to bring a statement made by Senior Associate Justice Carpio on Benham Rise. Just a little bit of background.
Sure.
We brought this to the fore back in 2009 to the United Nations, and it was former Chief Justice Hilario Davide who actually presented this before the United Nations, because he was the Philippines representative, Philippine permanent representative to the United Nations. The former Chief Justice was the one who presented this. And then in 2012, it was awarded to us. Now, Justice Carpio also talked about this, and we'll put it up on the screen, Congressman. He says that under international law, Benham Rise is not part of the Philippine national territory. How do you understand that? Because
yes, it's about the territorial waters. Our bounds of territory is the 12 nautical miles from the baseline.
Right. And then let's
200 nautical miles is the exclusive economic zone.
And then over and above that is the extended
continental shelf.
Continental shelf. Let's put back the statement of Associate Justice Carpio. And then he says, under Article 77 of UNCLOS, there you go. We have the sovereign right to explore and exploit the oil, gas, and other mineral resources in Benham Rise. Do you agree?
Yes, agreed.
What does it really say? Na ang Pilipinas lang ang pwedeng mag-explore ng Benham Rise. Wala ng ibang bansa.
Oh, yun yung maliwanag na sinabi sa UNCLOS. May provision pa dyan which says that even if we don't use it, we still have the exclusive right to it. Other countries cannot just come in and exploit it.
Even if we don't use it for the next 1,000 years?
Yes.
100 years? Atin pa rin siya.
Inherent sa atin yung karapatan to use it.
So,
now, kasi nga, go along with the rights to explore and exploit, I believe, goes along the right to defend our right. So we have I think we are in the proper position to question those who are moving into an area where we have rights.
Which the DFA already did by sending a note verbal. And then on the last statement of Justice Carpio, he said that other states like China, here we go, have the right to conduct in Benham Rise. One, fishery research. I would call that marine research, as they had mentioned. Pwede silang... They can conduct marine research there.
Excluded from our rights to exploit are marine animals, which are mobile, because they could they themselves could just be passing through.
They can move from one place to another. So
yes,
any country can do that.
So they can fish in the area.
Yeah, pwede yun.
Yeah. They can do research. That could be stretching it. They can always say we're doing research about fish,
right?
Or we can do research about the flow of water current.
Right.
They can use that as an excuse. But to me, we should guard our rights like a jealous husband.
But you know, when we were talking about it a while ago, you were saying, kunwari nga, you have a piece of land, kailangan maglagay ka ng fence doon. What can we do to show the world that we are guarding Benham Rise?
Yes, like I said, like we add equipment and material to our Air Force and our Navy and Coast Guard.
So it's really patrolling the area.
Patrolling, its presence. Put up that surveillance system. And one more thing. We should, this is diplomacy, by the way, because I have a term, passive diplomacy. And to me, what we're doing is passive diplomacy. We're just dealing with China at a distance, assuring them with our words.
Mm-mm.
But there's another angle to diplomacy. We can tap our allies to help us in the defense.
Like who?
The obvious answer there is the only naval power outside the
United
Pacific,
States.
The United States.
Mm-hmm. Is that something you suggest we do?
I would say so. I'd be open about it, because I am wary of China. I'll be open about it as well, because they have shown behavior which shows that they wouldn't blink at an opportunity to extend their reach, their power, their influence. And that's, I think, what they're doing.
So we have Benham Rise again on the east. When I was reading through the claim of the Philippines before the UN, mm-hmm. it was very technical, I'll have to admit that. But there was a point there that it said that no other country laid claim to Benham Rise. In yes. other words, it's undisputed.
Yes, because outside, beyond it, is already the wide open Pacific Ocean.
Exactly.
And, now, and we're the only ones right beside it.
Is it far off, do you think? Is it unimaginable that some other country will begin to question or lay claim to Benham Rise?
It might not be a real claim that it is ours. No? But I've come across material which talks about the island chain strategy of China.
What is that?
Okay, the island of there's something called the first island chain. It's an imaginary territory from Japan going south to the Philippines. There are chains of small islands there. So it's an imaginary boundary of defense. In their case, it could be considered an offense. And then there's a second island chain beyond that. And in between what they refer to as a first island chain and the second island chain is Benham Rise. So, you know, the relevance of what Secretary Lorenzana said, that they might be doing topographical survey of the underwater landscape for submarines.
That's right.
It could be a prelude to them sending submarine patrols in that area.
Mm.
They can't build structures,
mm-hmm.
but by sending submarines, that could be an initial foray into that area. And if they get used, if the people, the world gets used to them having presence there, that's already a step forward going to that second island chain
really?
That you're talking about. What they've put up in West Philippine Sea is already a forward base. From there, they can launch the patrols. Just tatawin
yeah,
lang yan ang ganun sa kabilang
side. It's the exact opposite. We're talking about the east.
That's just a matter of
yeah,
travel
but there's
for
a,
them.
May land mass that separates.
Tatawid lang siya. I mean, that they can do that. You know, submarines can
so
travel long
distances. So you're saying that it's
distances.
Not far off that China could possibly say one day that...
Yeah, it is. To me, it's a creeping invasion into areas where we have rights. Let's not be... to me, I'm guarding our interests like a jealous husband. I don't think their intentions are that innocent.
Mm-hmm.
It's better for us to be safe that way, thinking that way. That's
yeah.
how security works. That's
yeah.
that should be the mindset
but,
of national
but
security.
But we can always go to that UNCLOS report saying that no note verbals were sent to the United Nations or the United Nations law or the UNCLOS. Nobody laid claim to the Benham Rise.
Yes, that's the...
And we're talking about something very recent. That started in 2009 and awarded in 2012. I mean, this did not happen 100 years ago.
But remember that there was also a favorable decision for us on the West Philippine Sea. But look what happened.
They ignored it.
They ignored it.
And then yet they're using that the UNCLOS awarding us also
they,
the Benham
they
Rise.
Will use it to their advantage. They, mm-hmm. they will use an argument to their advantage.
Yeah.
But the fact of international relations is that countries are selfish.
Mm-hmm.
So,
especially if they're, you know, it's rich in minerals, oil. Yeah.
They don't, countries don't relate to other countries out of the goodness of their hearts. They have their own interests.
When do you think the House will begin its probe on what happened in Benham Rise?
Well, I filed my resolution only yesterday. Unfortunately, we're going on recess this week.
Yeah.
Then we're coming back first week of May. Hopefully, it gets referred to the committee and the committee will give priority to it.
Very interesting to really look into and focus and what kind of legislation can be...
What I'm thinking of now is a bill that would set the policy of developing a security strategy for Benham Rise. appropriating funds to give life to the security plan. That's what I am thinking of right
for
now.
For now, at least.
Yes.
Yeah. Again, we go back to what you call step one. Umpisahan na muna natin.
Yes, bakuran muna
natin. Bakuran muna natin ang Benham Rise. Yeah. Are you also open to possibly doing a joint venture with a private company?
I don't know how it would play out. It depends on what kind of what kind of facilities. Like, for example, if building an airfield in that part of the country is adopted, then probably a private sector could have a part in it,
right?
Because it can be multi-use. Yeah.
I wish we had more time, Congressman. Wanted to talk about the death penalty. Anyway, that's passed. You have been a proponent of the death penalty,
yes.
But you also have a bill on really having bicycle lanes in the country.
Yeah.
So very briefly, sir, 30 seconds, please. Yung sa bill mo on bicycle lanes, hindi napapansin.
Basically, putting a policy on safety for bicycle riders. Can I throw in another bill that I filed yesterday because of that incident where an old lady got run over? I'm filing an amendment to the distracted driving law because the distracted driving law only covers operation of devices.
Okay.
It doesn't have a provision on wearing earphones while driving.
Uh-huh. So you want that?
The driver was saying that he was wearing earphones. Uh-huh. He did not hear that there was an incident.
So it's time to put that in. Congressman Ruffy Biazon, sir, maraming salamat po sa inyo.
Thank you.
This is The Source on CNN Philippines. When we come back,